Well, dear students, good morning to you all. Today our topic consignment continuation only. Previously you have taken the consignment topic. We covered what is consignment, what is the difference between the consignment and sale, how to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignor, and how to value the closing stock. That all we covered, and whatever the remaining part we are going to cover in this class. Okay, please listen sincerely. Here, certain terms are written, I am going to explain. Number one, pro forma invoice. Pro forma invoice is the statement sent by consignor to consignee, showing the particulars of goods sent, their prices, quality, quantity, etc. Clear? Pro forma invoice is the statement sent by consignor to consignee. Now, account sales. It is the statement sent by consignee to consignor. We are receiving. We means consignor. We are receiving from consignee. It is the statement sent by consignee to consignor, showing the particulars of his sales, his commission, his expenses, and balance or advance, how much he already given and how much the balance left. They are all clearly explained in that particular statement which is sent by consignee to consignor. You have to remember, this is the statement sent by consignor to consignee. But if the statement sent by consignee to consignor. Understand? Next, commission. Generally, first ordinary commission, we are giving certain percentage on sales. Certain percentage on sales. Commission to consignee because he is our agent. We are giving ordinary commission on sales. On sales. Here, two more important terms are there, commissions are there. One is temporary commission. Temporary commission is the additional commission given to consignee so as to avoid the bad debts loss. Bad debts loss. What is a bad debt? When I sold on credit basis, if the amount not yet recovered, if it is recovered, then we can say it is a bad debt. If there is a loss of bad debts, we have to suffer. We means consignor has to suffer. That's why we are giving an incentive to consignee. Well, my dear friend, take extra commission, but don't sell on credit basis. If you sell on credit basis, if there is any bad debts loss, you have to suffer. You have to suffer. So whenever I am giving temporary commission, bad debts loss goes to consignee. I don't bother. But whenever there is no temporary commission, that bad debts loss also to be suffered by consignor. To be suffered by consignor. Understanding or not? Last and final, once again, temporary commission is the commission given to consignee additionally so as to avoid the loss of bad debts. Understanding? When temporary commission is given, loss goes to consignee. When there is no temporary commission, we have to suffer. We means consignor. Next. Overriding commission. It is also the additional commission given when the consignee is sold more than the invoice price. I already told to consignee, please sell the goods for 50,000. Well, my dear consignee, please sell it for 50,000. But our consignee, our agent is a good boy. He sold it more than the invoice price. So on that excess, on that surplus, we are giving additional commission. Understand? I asked you to sell for 50,000, but the consignee is sold for 60,000. Excess how much is there? 10,000. On that 10,000, I will give additional commission. Generally, it is more rate than the ordinary commission. More rate. Suppose if I am giving ordinary commission 5%, overriding commission, I will give you 10% or 15%. Like that. Understand? Next and last our topic, normal and abnormal loss. Normal loss, it is a natural loss expected loss revenue loss. Like leakage, shortage in weight, natural damage or wastage, it is not valued, not recorded, but adjusted in closing stock. Adjusted in? Well, my dear students, normal loss is a natural loss and it is expected loss based on past experience we know. It is unavoidable, we can't control, we cannot avoid. Like leakage, at the time of loading and unloading of oil or water, there will be some short leakage. Then shortage in weight, shortage in weight. Or sometimes there may be a natural damages. Natural damages. They are all come under the normal losses. They need not to be valued. No need to value. And no need to record in the books of accountancy. They cannot be recovered also. And they are adjusted. That normal loss is adjusted in the closing stock valuation. Closing stock valuation. How it is adjusted? Just I am explaining here. Look here. Suppose consignor is sending 1000 cases of oil or liters of oil at the rate of 10 rupees. That is equal to 10,000 rupees. 1000 cases of oil sent or liters of oil sent at the rate of 10 rupees. Its value 10,000. Consignor direct expenses like carriage, freight and etc. For example, 1000. So our total cost is 11,000. Total cost is 11,000. Out of 1000 kgs, when we are sending on the way, during the way, there is a leakage of 10 kgs. That means consignee received only 990 kgs are received by consignee. Once again, well, my dear students, my dear friends, 1000 kgs of oil is sent at the rate of 10 rupees, that is equal to 10,000. Consignor expenses, direct expenses, which are non-recurring expenses, which are paid only once, 1000. So total cost is equal, total value is equal to 11,000. During the way, on the way, 10 kgs are leakage. So 990 kgs are received by consignee. This is the value of 990 kgs that you have to understand. Don't think that they are 1000 kgs. They are only 990 kgs. They are only 990 kgs. Now, consignee sold 900 kgs. Now, how many unsold? 90. This is called unsold stock. Now, how to value closing stock? Closing stock is equal unsold units by consignee received units into total cost. Into total cost. Now tell me amounts. Unsold units are 90 divided by consignee received units are 990 into 11,000. That is equal to 1,000 rupees. 90 is unsold units now. Divided by 990 cases received by consignee now. Into total value, total cost 11,000. 11 nines are, 9 ones are cancelled. So that is equal to 1,000 rupees. Understand or not? This is the system of value in closing stock when there is normal loss. When there is normal loss. When there is normal loss, this is the way what you have to follow. But generally what we will do here, unsold units by total units we will take in general case, in ordinary case. But only when there is normal loss, we have to follow like this. Unsold units by consignee received units into total cost, that is equal to units of valuation. Well, dear students, please take down. Then I will go to abnormal loss and goods sent at invoice price. Goods sent at invoice price. That two parts we have to cover. Well, now abnormal loss. Abnormal loss is an unexpected loss accidental loss like theft, fire or any other accidents. It must be valued It must be recorded and it can be recovered through insurance. It can be recovered through insurance. Once again, abnormal loss is an accidental loss and unexpected loss like theft, fire or any other accidents. The abnormal loss must be valued as like closing stock at cost only. Abnormal loss must be valued as like closing stock at cost only, at the cost only. It must be valued, it must be recorded in the books of accounts, and it can be recovered through insurance. Abnormal loss can be avoided, we can control through our proper control and what it is called checking, whatever it may be. We can control to certain extent. So, abnormal loss is entirely different to normal loss. It must be valued. It is valued as like closing stock at cost. When abnormal loss is valued, abnormal loss account debtor to consignment account. Suppose abnormal loss valued as 10,500. Out of 10,500, we recovered from insurance company 8,000 rupees. How much we recovered? 8,000. Then, insurance company account debtor out of 10,500, we recovered already 8,000, still loss 2,500. That goes to profit and loss account. Profit and loss account debtor 2,500 to abnormal loss account. Well, dear students, following or not? Once again, abnormal loss is an accidental and unexpected loss. It must be valued as like closing stock at cost only. And it must be recorded in the books like this only. Two generalities are required. For number one, when the abnormal loss is valued, abnormal loss account debtor to consignment account. Abnormal loss account debtor to consignment account. When we recovered, suppose we recovered 8,000, still there is a loss of 2,500. Insurance company account debtor 8,000, how much we are going to receive? Profit on the loss account debtor 2,500, how much still there is loss? To abnormal loss account 10,500. Okay, Babu. Now, last and final when goods are sent at invoice price. What is invoice price? Whenever we are sending goods to consignee, we have given a price at which goods are to be sold. We already given a price. Well, my dear consign, please sell these goods for 52,000. For 52,000. Previously, in the previous class, we have taken the goods sent is equal to 40,000. In the previous problem, we have taken 40,000. It is the original cost. We added certain profit. Suppose 30% we added. That means I asked the consignee that to sell for 52,000. That is called invoice price. Well, dear students, once again, invoice price is nothing but the sale price at which consignee has to sell. Invoice price is the sale price at which consignee has to sell. Actually, its original cost is 40,000. I asked, please sell it for 52,000 by adding certain rate of profit. I fixed the invoice price. Sir, why, sir, we are adding like that? What is the importance or what is its need? Whenever I am telling a certain price at which it is to be sold, automatically the consignee must sell for 52,000 or more than 52,000. So 100% we will get profit. First of all, we will get 100% profit. Not only that, all the goods are sold at uniform price. Some are at so-and-so price, some are at some other price, not like that. Uniform price. Please sell the pen for 20 rupees. So automatically he has to sell for 20 or more than 20. I sold for 18, not like that. He must sell at a certain price. So uniform price will be there. Next, how much profit earned by consignor cannot be known to consignee. It is a business secret. It is a business secret. Understanding. If I am telling him that my cost is 40,000, whenever he sold for 50,000, he can understand how much profit I earned. So in this case, it is not possible. So this is the importance of invoice price. It is only going on, you know, all over the world. Everywhere there is already, for every item, for every product, there is a price, tag price, listed price, quotation price, whatever it may be, invoice price, sale price. He must sell at so-and-so price. Who has to sell? Consignee has to sell at so-and-so price. That price is called invoice price. That price is called
invoice price.
Clear? If we are giving such a price, means 100% will get profit, and he has to sell at a uniform prices, and then how much profit earned by consignor cannot be known to consignee. Now, in this case, first I will take consignment account, return to goods and return consignment, invoice price I will take, 52,000. Invoice price I am taking. Consignment account, debit to cash, consignor expenses taken. Consignment account, debit to consignee, consignee expenses taken. Consignee sold 3/4 part for 44,000. I am taking all the figures I got into the previous problem. Buy B, sales. He sold for 44,000, 3/4 part only. So there is a closing stock, unsold stock. Stock on consignment. What it is called? Stock on consignment. Well, now I am taking closing stock here. We have to take 1/4 of invoice price. Plus consignor expenses. How much? 1,000. By 1/4. Consignee expenses, if they are non-recurring, if they are direct expenses like carriage, freight, unloading charges, you can add If not, no need to add. So closing stock is equal to 13,250. 13,250. Buy stop on consignment, 13,250. On this sales, we are taking 5% commission, 2B commission, 2,205%. Well, dear students, these are all, almost all the same items as like in the previous problem, but now we are going to take two more steps. Number one, here we have taken 52,000 invoice price, but its actual price is 40,000. How much its actual price?
40,000.
How much excess is there? How much loading is there? How much profit is there? 12,000. Actually, it's cost 40,000, but we have taken 52,000 invoice price. How much excess is there? 12,000. That is called loading or profit. Or difference between the cost price and invoice price. Cost price and invoice price. That is equal 12,000. I am taking reverse by GSC. For this entry, consignment account or to goods and on consignment. So as to reduce to its cost price, I am taking the reverse entry. Goods sent on consignment account or to consignment. So 12,000 I have taken on reverse side. Understand? Last and final, 1/4 stock is unsold, na? Out of 40,000, 1/4 means 10,000 only. Out of 40,000, 1/4, 10,000 only. But I have taken 1/4 of 52,000. Understand? Actually, cost is 40,000, 1/4 becomes 10,000 only. Closing stock, original cost, 10,000 only. But we have taken here 13,000. So 3,000 excess is there. That is called stock reserve or stock suspense account. What it is called? Stock reserve or stock suspense. So to make it reduced to cost price, I am taking here stock reserve. Stock reserve. How much? 3,000. That's over. Now you can make it balance. Profit is equal 10,250. We got the same profit in the previous example. Previous example, what we solved in the previous class. Understand? Then we are getting the same profit there and here. When you sent goods at cost or when you sent goods at invoice price, the profit is same. But only the difference. Here first we have taken invoice price, it is reduced. Then closing stock is also valued at invoice price, again it is reduced. So in the case of invoice price, two more points are extra. Understanding or not? Once again, last and final, goods sent at invoice price. Invoice price means it is the price which is more than the cost after adding certain amount of profit. $40,000 its original cost. We added 30%, 12,000. Its invoice price became 52,000. It is called invoice price or sale price at which the consignee has to sell. How much excess we added? 12,000. It is called profit. Some are using the word loading. How much loaded? 3,000. Then, generally I will use the word difference. 40,000 is the cost, 52,000 is invoice price, the difference is equal to 12,000. That difference we have taken here. And the closing stock also, valued at invoice price first time, and then it is reduced to cost price. Again we have taken the 1/4 of difference. What is this called? 1/4 of difference. Original cost is 10,000. As per invoice price, 13,000. How much excess? 3,000. You can get that 3,000 in this way also. 12,000 is the total difference. In that you can get directly 1/4. where the students take down, and then I will go through some small topic, how to add this profit, how to add. Okay, just wait. Well, dear students, almost all I covered consignment topic from the beginning. What is consignment? Difference between consignment and sale. Then how to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignor, and some theoretical aspects also I explained. What is normal and abnormal losses? And then I told last year, goods sent at invoice price. Goods sent at invoice price. Well, dear students, some are asking me number of times, sir, whenever cost price is given, how to calculate invoice price? Or whenever the invoice price is given, how to calculate cost price? Some confusion is there. Right now I am explaining that part only. Here, 20% profit added to cost. 20% profit added to cost. That means, if the cost is 100, they added 20% profit means 20 added. How much is the sale price or invoice price? Once again, 20% profit added to cost. If the cost is 100, profit added 20. So invoice price or sale price becomes 120. This is an equation or a proportion. Whenever you know cost price, you can find out invoice price. Or whenever you know invoice price, you can find out cost price. Understanding? Suppose cost price 40,000. Then how much invoice price you can put a question mark? 40,000 into 120 divided by 100. Understanding or not? The cost price of a particular item is 100. They added 20 profit. They fixed the price 120. If the cost is 100, invoice is 120. Suppose the cost price is 40,000, how much invoice price you can find out? That is called cross multiplication. Cross multiplication. 40,000 into 120 divided by 100. We get. Suppose you know invoice price. I want cost price. Then 48,000 into 100 divided by 120, you can get the cost price. So if cost price given, you can find out invoice price. If invoice price given, we can find out cost price. Understanding or not? Clear? One more model. This, there are only two models in the world. In the world. Why? Because there is cost price, there is invoice price. Two chances only. So, here you added profit to cost. Come to here. 20% profit on invoice price. That means, if the invoice price is 100, in that only profit is there 20, so my cost must be 80 only. If the less only cost, I will get profit. If not, I will get, how can I get profit? In this case, I added 20, I got the invoice price. In this case, I deducted the 20, I got the cost price. Understanding or not? Sir, why we assumed this 100? In this case, we assumed 100 here. Why like that? Here, 20% on cost given. Percentage is given on cost, so cost is assumed as 100. Here the percentage is given on invoice price. So invoice price is assumed as 100. Suppose, after my death, I will give half property to my son. So property is assumed as 100. The percentage given on what that must be assumed as 100% means per period 100. Not percent means like this. Percent means for every 100. For every 100 invoice price, I am going to get 20 rupees profit. That means my cost must be 80 only. So, here 80, 20, 100 is there. If I know cost price, I can find out the invoice price. 40,000 into 100 by 80. That is equal to 50,000. Understand? Suppose I know invoice price. 50,000 into 80 by 100. I will get the cost price. I will get the cost price. Understanding or not? There are only two models. There are only two models. Either percentage on cost given or percentage on invoice price given. If percentage is given on cost, cost is assumed as 100. If the percentage is given on invoice price only assumed as 100. Understand? Now, some may say, suppose 100, 20 added, that is equal to 120 now. This is the cost, this is the invoice price. In this middle, profit is there. This 20 is the profit out of 100, if the cost is available. If 20 is the profit out of 120 invoice price, wherever invoice price is available. That means, if you are having cost, 20 by 100. If you are having invoice price, 20 by 120. Then you will get the loaded part to profit part. 20 out of 100 is equal to 1 by 5. It is also called 20%. 20 out of 120 is called 1 by 6. It is also called 16.66%. 100 to 125. 25 added. This 25 out of 100, that is equal to 1 by 4. This 25 out of 125, that is equal to 1 by 5. Suppose 50% added. 100 plus 50, that is equal to 150. This 50 out of 100, 1 by 2. This 50 out of 150, that is equal to 1 by 3. Understand it or not? 20 is a common figure. When you are calculating on cost, 20 by 100 you can calculate, you will get the profit. When you are calculating on invoice price, you have to calculate 20 by 120, not 20 by 100. Understand? Here also, 25 out of 100, 1 by 4, 25%. 25 out of 125, 1 by 5, 20%. 50 out of 100, 1 by 2, 50%. 50 out of 150, that is called 1/3, 33%. Understand? Instead of remembering all this, it is the better way you can follow. Cost price given, invoice you can easily find out. Invoice price given, cost price you can find out. Added means cost plus percentage is added. That is called invoice price. But in this case, percentage is given on invoice price. Invoice price only 100. Minus profit is equal to cost. Understanding or not? If you understand, you can do in any way, different ways you can follow. Not understand what I can do. So please follow once again. Don't it? Here, percentage may be on cost, may be on invoice. Cost given, find out invoice. Invoice given, find out cost. This case, there are only two cases. Okay? See you all in the next class.